Hello everyone, this is Mayurvaz. In this video, I'm going to tell you about the resources and tips to rock your coding interview. These resources were followed by the people who now hold offers from Microsoft, Uber, Flipkart, Amazon. So please follow these resources thoroughly. Data structures and algorithms. Data structures and algorithms are of prime importance. These top firms pay a lot of attention on your data structures and algorithm skills. And 90 to 95% of your interview will be based on data structures and algorithms. Top sites from which you can prepare are Geeks for Geeks, Leetcode, InterviewBit. I'm going to share the link of the articles from these sites, the questions you must do. Okay, one important thing is be regular on Codeforces. So before your interviews, you will be appearing for online coding rounds. And those who clear those online coding rounds will only be called for the interviews, right? So those online coding rounds would be very similar to the competitions hold on Codeforces. So regular do diff to competitions, try to do questions with tags A, B, and C. So increase your coding speed, improve implementation skills. It will also help you to develop the ability to think of edge cases. It will also help you to improve your error finding ability. And these skills will help you a lot in your online coding rounds, right? One most important thing is before your interviews, check out Geeks for Geeks interview experience archives. Okay, this is must to do. From Geeks for Geeks, you must do this article, must do coding questions company wise, right? So there are around 200 questions with company tags and questions asked in those companies. So try out all these questions and try to complete these questions in 20 days, right? After that, you can move to your interview bit. So there are sections. So questions are divided into sections based on the algorithms and data structures. So you must have done 90% of questions over here in Geeks for Geeks. So the remaining questions, you can do them from here. And after you have completed interview bit, okay, try to complete these questions in 5 to 6 days, the remaining questions only. After that, you can move to your Leetcode. So there are around 1300 plus questions. So you can try medium and hard level questions. And if you want to do according to company tags, this is the link. It consists of the questions asked in those companies. So try out these questions like regular expression matching. It's a hard question asked in Google. So question ID is 10. So just go to that 10 number and you can do this question, right? So this is Codeforces, right? It consists of competitions similar to those that you will be giving for online coding rounds. So try to do the questions with tags A, B, and C, right? And try to do these competitions in a week. You must do at least 3 competitions, right? To develop your speed and other skills, okay? And before every company interview, you should check out these interview experiences of those companies. Like let's open DSHOP. So these are the interview experiences of people who have appeared for DSHOP, and you must do these interview experiences as well, right? So these interview experiences will help you to understand what kind of questions and what kind of interview that company takes, okay? Now let's discuss the tips for acing your online coding round. So what happens in online coding round is that you get some 2 to 4 problems to solve in around 1 to 2 hours. So number of problems and time depends on your company you are applying for, right? So the most important thing is speed. You should have good and quick implementation, right? Because what happens many a times is that you may fail to attempt a coding question which was easy and solvable, and you knew the concept of that question, right? So this should not happen. You should have good speed. For this thing only, I recommend you to do Codeforces, which I talked about in previous slide, okay? Brute forcing, if you don't know the most optimal solution. solve it partially using brute force, right? Because partial solution may also fetch you some points. Use STL or collection library instead of implementing your own data structures or your own functions. Try to use the inbuilt functions because that will save time. First attempt problems which you find solvable, which you find easy, so that you have some set of points, some set of solved questions, and then go for problems which are hard. Okay. While giving your interview, you should pay attention on these steps. Okay, so to give a good coding interview round, so when the interviewer gives you the question, just repeat that question to the interviewer to avoid any miscommunication or misinterpretation. After that, you should ask any clarifying doubts, if any, to make requirements clear. Okay, for example, if my interviewer gives me a question based on array, then I must ask that, does the array consist of negative integers, for example, so that I can come up with an algorithm which also works for the negative integers. Okay, then start with few test cases. Thinking how you can get the answer of those test cases will only lead you to the solution. Think loud so that interviewer can note your thought process, can guide you to the correct solution, and can know what you are thinking, what all you can think. Okay, come up with a solution as quickly as possible, even if it is not the efficient one. Then slowly build the most efficient solution. Okay, don't waste your time directly jumping on the most efficient solution. First think of a basic solution, then optimize it, then optimize it. Don't miss edge cases. Okay, ignoring the edge cases is the huge red flag. You should always think of the edge cases. Don't ignore hints given by the interviewer. Ignoring them is huge red flag. Taking hints is okay, but after that you should come to a solution. Okay, if you are stuck, go through your approach with the interviewer and discuss where you are stuck. Most interviewers will guide you to a solution. Okay, after coding your solution, try run the code for a test case. Think before you speak. You should also practice coding on Google Docs and on paper. Okay, and the most important thing is be calm. Okay, and don't take tension of what will happen. Just be calm and do your best. Now, before moving forward, I would like to tell that the resources and tips mentioned from this slide are for university graduates who are looking for the jobs, or for students studying in universities and are looking for internships. Okay, so let's discuss how you should talk about your projects. So you should know everything about your projects, the algorithm you have used in your project, the technologies you have used, everything about those technologies and the algorithms. Now, how to talk about your projects? First, give introduction about your project and what technologies you used in your project. Okay, then what are the basic features of your project, what input it requires from the user, and what output it produces, like then the flow of data and flow of control, design of your models, algorithms working behind, and what you learned from this project. Okay, so suppose for a web app project, I'll tell about what that web app do, what input it takes from the user, what output it produce. Then in a web app, for the flow of data and control, I'll talk about the MVC model. From that, the models I have designed in my web app, the data which is stored in that models, which column I've made a primary key, what is my foreign key, etc. Algorithms working behind, for example, if I'm using a BFS algorithm, then why BFS algorithm, what is the complexity of that algorithm, and what thing I learned from that project. Okay, now some of the other relevant subjects that are important for your interviews are object-oriented programming and object-oriented design, computer language. So computer language, your preferred language, the language in your code, you should know about that language, operating systems, computer networks, database management system. So all these subjects, we study all these subjects in our colleges. in our curriculum, right? And finally, the system design, right? For the people who code in Java, okay, you guys can check out the Geeks for Geeks articles on Java. So there are many such articles and all the information about Java. So you should cover the overviews, basics, OOPs concept and all these concepts till your file handling and collections in Java, right? And collection classes, you can ignore the advanced features, image processing, networking in Java. You can ignore all these things if you're not using these things in your project, okay? So for your basic coding, you should know till your collections in Java. For C++ people, you can use this Geeks for Geeks C++ article page, and there are many such articles. You should know all these informations. You can ignore C++ advanced puzzles and your C++ in competitive programming, but you should know about the OOPs, about array, strings, functions, constructors, dynamic memory allocation, function overloading, all this stuff. You should know all this stuff, okay? For operating system, again, Geeks for Geeks, right? Main topics are this basics, CPU scheduling, process synchronization, deadlock, processes and threads. Threads are one of the most important, and memory management, file and disk management, right? For your database management, okay? Again, Geeks for Geeks, you should do introduction, your ER model, relation model, your functional dependencies, normalizations, transactions, indexing, B and B plus trees, okay? And SQL, okay? SQL is also important. For your computer networks, you should know about your data lake layers, the protocols, working on that layer, network layer, transport layer, application layer, all these layers. You should know about the protocols that are working in those layers, okay? For system design, you should do this Gaurav Sain playlist of system design. It is the best system design resource out there on the internet. You can watch all these 23 videos, and these are the best videos, okay? If you like this video, if you find this video informative, please like, subscribe and share this video, okay? And thank you so much for watching, and good luck for your interview preparation.